Hello, class 9th. So today we are going to finish this chapter number 9, force and laws of motion. Yes, today we are going to finish the chapter. So the last topic that we studied was Newton's third law of motion. Okay, so today let's do a work. First of all, let's revise all the topic of Newton's law of motion. Okay, let's study in brief. Today's class is not long, so first of all, we will revise all the topic. Okay, then we will move to the next point. Okay, so the last topic that we studied was Newton's third law of motion. Yes, this topic we study. So as you can see on the screen, Newton's third law of motion. So according to Newton's third law of motion, to every action there is an equal and opposite reaction, and they act on two different body. Yes, one body act on another body, another body act on first body. So example of action and reaction, you know that when a bullet is fired from a gun, it exerts a forward force on the bullet, which is actually the exert action, and the bullet exert an equal and opposite force on the gun, which is actually a reaction. So the gun recoil. And we also studied one more example, that when a sailor jump out of a boat, he exert a backward force of the boat, and the boat exert an equal and opposite force on the sailor, and the sailor jump forward. Yes, so we studied all these. And what is Newton's first law of motion state? Newton's first law of motion state that an object remains in a state of rest or in a uniform motion in a straight line unless compelled to change the state applied by the force. Okay, and we know that examples and Newton's first law of motion is also known as motion of inertia. And what is inertia? Inertia is the natural tendency of the object to remain in a state of rest or in uniform motion. Yes, and we know the example that if the striker hit a pile of a coin, if a striker hit a pile of coin, and then what will happen? The lowest coin will move out, and the remaining coin will fall down due to the inertia of rest. And if a coin is placed on a card over a tumbler, is flicked with a finger due to inertia of rest, the coin will fall down into the tumbler. Okay, and when we are standing in a bus, the bus begins to move, suddenly we tend to fall backward because our feet are in contact with the floor, which is actually in motion. So our legs also in the motion, but our upper part of the body continue to remain at rest due to inertia of rest. That's why we fall backward. And the same way, when we travel in a car and the driver applies the brake, suddenly we tend to fall forward due to the inertia of motion, because we are in the motion with the car, because our body is in contact with the seat of the car. Yes, and what is Newton's second law of motion? Newton's second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to the applied force in the direction of force. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, so in previous class I asked you a question, that why does the rocket moves upward? Why does the rocket move upward? So the answer is in front of you. So you know, when the ISRO or NASA, yes, Indian Space Research Organization, or NASA, National Administrative Service Organization, so when they fire the rocket, that time actually what happens, the gases will come out, the burning gases will come out from the bottom part. Yes, So when the rocket is fired, then the burning gases will come out. Yes. So the exert a pressure, which is actually a action, and the rocket will go. The rocket will go forward. Yes, the rocket will go forward. At the same time, the rocket will also apply the friction. At the same time, the rocket will also apply the pressure. Yes, definitely apply. So what happens? So when a rocket is fired, that time what happens? The force of burning gases come out. The force of burning gases will come out. Yes, the force of burning gases will come out, which is actually an action. Yes, which is actually the applied by the rocket. Now when the burning gases will come out, at the same the burning gases will apply a force on the rocket. Yes, which is a reaction. So that's why the rocket moves upward. Yes, when a rocket is fired, the force of burning gases coming out, which exert an equal and opposite force on the rocket. Yes, which is actually a reaction, and it moves upward. It moves upward. Yes. So the rocket apply a force on hot gases, which is an action, and the hot gases applied a force on the rocket, which is a reaction. Yes, the force applied by hot gases on a rocket is a reaction, and the rocket apply a force on hot gases, which is an action. Okay. And you know, if you might have seen a balloon, that if you when a balloon is filled with air, when an air filled balloon is released, that time what happens? If you will open the mouth of the balloon, then what will happen? The air will come out. The air will come out. Yes. At that time, the balloon applied the force on the air, which is coming out air, which is action. And when the air is coming out, the air will apply the force on the balloon, which is a reaction. Yes. So when an air filled balloon exert, when an air filled balloon is released, when an air filled balloon is released, the force of the air coming out of the balloon apply an equal and opposite force on the balloon, and it moves upward. Yes, in the same way, when the gases coming out of the from the rocket apply the force of force equal they apply the equal and opposite force on the rocket, that's why it moves upward. Yes, I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, let's study about the conservation of momentum. Yes, so what is conservation of momentum? So according to the conservation of momentum, the sum of momentum of two object before collision will be equal to the sum of momentum after collision. Yes. And you know, you already know what is momentum. You already know that what is momentum. Momentum is actually the product of momentum on a body is actually the product of mass and velocity. Yes, P is equal to mv. Yes, remember this formula. So according to conservation of momentum, the sum of momentum of two object before collision, yes, before striking, suppose that there are two car, they are moving with the same velocity, having this with the same velocity, and having different mass. So before collision, their momentum will be equal to the momentum after collision. Yes, after collision means when the velocity will increase, when the velocity will change from initial velocity to final velocity, when they will do the collision, that time the momentum of both initial momentum and final momentum will always equal. So it is just like the law of conservation of energy. Yes, you know, conservation of energy, it says that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Yes, means the energy before creation is equal to the energy after destroy. So it can neither create nor destroy. So the energy was always conserved. In the same way, momentum is always conserved. So the sum of the momentum of two objects, the sum of the momentum of two objects, sum of the momentum means P1 plus P2 will always be equal to the momentum after collision. Yes. And there is no unbalanced force acting on them. Yes. No unbalanced force. That means that the total momentum of two objects is unchanged or conserved. Yes. Means the momentum is conserved by collision. Yes. Suppose there are two balls, okay? As you can see on the screen, there are two balls, A ball and B ball, okay? Suppose the mass of A ball, suppose the mass of A ball is MA and the mass of B ball is MB, okay? And A ball is, suppose the velocity, initial velocity of A ball is UA and the initial velocity of B ball is UB, okay? And so they have some momentum, okay, and when they will strike to each other, suppose when they collide with each other, that time they apply force on each other. Suppose A ball apply the force on B ball is FBA and the P ball apply the force on A ball is FAB. So both the force will also be opposite to each other, yes, but equal. Yes, so FBA will be equal to FAB. Yes, so after collision, when they collide to each other, their velocity change. Yes, the velocity of A ball, which is actually UA, it changes and the final velocity will become VA, and the velocity of the velocity of B ball, which is actually UB, it changes and become VB, which in t time, yes, in t time their velocity changes, okay, from final velocity to initial velocity, okay. If two balls A and B whose mass is MA and MB are traveling in a straight line, yes, are traveling in straight line with initial velocity UN and UB, yes, suppose the velocity, initial velocity U is more than UB, okay. When the ball will collide with any, then what will happen? And then during collision at a time t, and at a time t, the ball A exert a force on ball B, which is FAB, and the ball B exert a force on ball A, which is actually FBA. And if VA and VB are two velocity after collision, if the V and VB are the velocity of ball A and B after collision, then the momentum of ball A and ball B, which is actually after collision, the momentum of ball A before and after collision will be MA UA and MA VA, and the momentum of ball B will be after collision MB UB and MB VB, yes, before and after collision. Yes, this will be the momentum and it will be conserved. Let's prove it. Okay. Let's move on to the next point. So kids, remember we have two balls A and B. Before collision, they are traveling with different velocity. A ball is traveling with UA velocity. B ball is traveling with UB velocity. The mass of A ball is MA. The mass of B ball is MB. When they collide, they applied force. A ball applied FAB force on B ball. B ball applied FBA force on A ball. After collision, their velocity changes. Their velocity become, the A ball velocity become VA and the B ball velocity become VB. So before colliding, the momentum of A ball is MA UA, and after colliding, the momentum of A ball is MBVB, and sorry, MAVA, okay, and before colliding the momentum of B ball is MBUB, and after colliding the momentum will become MBVB. Yes, so as you can see on the screen, we will prove it easily by the Newton's second law of motion, because we know according to Newton's second law of motion the rate of change in momentum will be directly proportional to applied force. Yes, so change in momentum of a ball A will become MAVA minus MAUA. Yes, and if we talk about the change in momentum of ball B, it will become MBVB and minus MBUB. Yes, so the change in momentum of a ball during collision will become MAVA minus MAUA, means final velocity minus initial velocity. And if we talk rate of change of momentum, whenever we talk rate of change of momentum, then we will divide by t time. So it will become MAVA minus MAUA divided by t, because MA is actually constant. So it will become MA into VA minus UA upon t. Yes, and you know that rate of change in momentum is directly proportional to time, directly proportional to applied force. So it will become FAB is equal to MAVA minus UA upon t. Yes, now let's talk about the change of momentum for B ball. Change of momentum for B ball will be MBVB minus MBUB. Yes, and rate of change of momentum after collision, it will become MFBA is equal to MBVB minus UB divided by t. Yes, rate of change of momentum of B ball will be MB into VB minus UB divided by t. Yes, so according to Newton's third law of motion, the force FAB exerted by the ball A, FAB exerted by ball A on B ball will be equal and opposite to the force FBA exerted by B ball on A. Yes, both will be equal and opposite force. So FAB is equal to minus FBA. Minus sign we have used here to show the direction, which is actually opposite direction. That's why we have used minus sign. It is not negative value. Okay, so we will put the value FAB in the place of FAB. We will write MA into VA minus UA upon T, and in the place of minus FBA we will write the value minus MB VA minus U minus VB minus UB divided by T. Yes, so here T is common, so here T is common, so T will get cancelled. Yes, so the remaining value is MA into VA minus UA is equal to minus MB into VB minus UB. Yes, now we will multiply them, then the formula will become MA VA minus MA UA and minus MB VB plus MB UB. Yes, how? Because minus minus plus. Now we will transfer the value for initial velocity and final velocity will be transferred on one side, and the value of B ball will transfer on one side. Initial and final velocity will be transferred to each other. Then the value will become minus MA UA minus MA UA and minus MA VA minus MB VB. And when we will transfer again, then the formula will become MA UA plus MB UB is equal to MA VA plus MB VB. Yes, this is the formula. And here left side we have written MAUA plus MBUB, which is actually the value of initial momentum. Okay, initial momentum. And here on the right side MAVA plus MBVB, which is actually the final momentum. So the momentum of two ball before collision is equal to the momentum of two ball after collision. I hope you understood. Yes, So this equation is very important. There are many questions which depend upon this equation. You will have to resolve them. You will check out in your book. You will solve them. Okay, it's your duty to solve them. I hope you understood now. Let's move on the last point. So kids, it's time to ask question. Today is the last question and chapter is finished. Yes, the chapter is finished. In next class we will start chapter number 10, and I have written a note, solve the numericals. Yes, you will solve the numericals which are given in your notebook. Okay, if you have any issue you can ask me. So it's very easy chapter. So question number 1, I have written only one question: derive the formula of conservation of momentum. Yes, what is conservation of momentum? What is conservation of momentum? The sum of the momentum of two objects before collision is equal to the sum of the momentum after collision. Okay, provided there is no unbalanced force acting on them. Okay, so we can say that means that total momentum of the two objects is unchanged, or you can say conserved by collision. Yes, momentum will not change before and after. Okay, suppose if two balls A and B, suppose if two balls A and B whose mass is m, A and B, are traveling in a straight line with initial velocity, suppose the velocity is u n and u b, u is the initial velocity of A ball, u b is the initial velocity of B ball. Here remember u a is more than u b. Okay, so the two balls will collide with each other. Okay, suppose these two balls collide with each other, and during the collision the time is t. Yes, so the ball A exert a force FAB, the ball A exert a force which is FAB on B ball, and at the same time B also exert a force which is actually FPA on A ball. So after collision the velocity become VA and VB. Yes, VA is the final velocity of A ball, and VB is the final velocity of B ball. Okay, so the ball, if VA and VB are the velocity of A and B ball after collision, then the momentum of ball A, the momentum of ball A before and after collision will become MAUA and MAVA. Yes, here MAUA is the momentum of A ball before collision, and MAVA is the momentum of A ball after collision, and the momentum of ball B before and after collision will become MBUB and MBVB. Here MBUB is the momentum of B ball before collision, and MBVB is the momentum after collision. So the if we will do the calculation, we will do the derivation, then we will get the formula which is actually MAUA plus MBUB will be equal to MAVA plus MBVB. Okay, it is, we got it by the Newton's second law of motion, and according to Newton's third law of motion we know that every action has equal and opposite reaction. So here the force which is applied by both on each other when they collide with each other, the force will be FAB will be equal to FBA. So FAB is equal to minus FBA. Minus we have written because B is applying force on A which is in opposite direction. Yes, that's why we have shown. I hope you understood. You will do the practice of the derivation. Practice and practice is the only option. Yes, if you want to get the good marks, practice is the only option. And if you feel difficulty, I pray to the God that school may open soon, that I will explain. Okay, now we'll meet next class with a new chapter. Till then, bye bye.